Okay, hello guys, and welcome to today on Princess Anu TV. Today we are going to be discussing about reasons why you cannot crash. Yeah, reasons why you cannot crash on that aircraft. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Heart like this with your faithfulness and
are you not happy? Today is the day 10 in our 30 days video challenge, and I'm going to be giving you reasons yes, why you cannot crash. And generally I would like to talk about the accident reports that has been published, even online, like Boeing published a particular accident report, causes of accident, and I would just like to run it down before I give you the reasons why you cannot crash. If we get to look at it generally, 55% of crashes actually caused by pilot error. Yeah, they actually caused by the larger percentage, because it's a machine, and the aircraft is a machine, and you put human beings that have thinking faculty, you know what I mean, like human beings. So, and human beings are not perfect, though by the grace of God, we are all working towards perfection. We are not perfect. So, these errors can come in place. 17% of crashes are also caused by aircraft maintenance error. Maybe a mechanical error, or maybe due to the engineer, maybe made some mistakes and all, and errors can come. 13% is also caused by weather, and 8% is caused by sabotage. When we talk about sabotage, you talk about hijack criminals, in quote, criminals, for goodness sake, when they hijack the aircraft. This is what's going to happen. They sabotage it, and maybe they kill people, maybe due to one thing or the other, like when they say this country, Iraq and Iran, this one and this one is fighting. Those are the kind of things that happen. Maybe they want to kill, maybe there's someone to testify about a particular thing. I've watched a lot of movies like that, and you'll be like, wow, these are what we call sabotages. Okay, and the remaining 7% is caused by other factors. When I mean other factors, talking about maybe ATC not knowing the position of this aircraft and this aircraft, making them to collide, or maybe ground handling, they didn't handle the aircraft properly, and even an aircraft can even crash on the takeoff run, an aircraft can even crash during taxi, like a lot of things happen. So these are part of the things we're going to be discussing today. Okay, number one reason why you cannot crash is because you have a trained pilot. I need you to always have confidence in the pilots. You see, there's something, the pilot is trained and structured to take that aircraft and bring it down. And you should have across your mind that you're not the first passenger that pilot is flying. That pilot has been flying for years, and even if there's a new airline pilot, he's always assisted by a captain that has been flying for years. So for goodness sake, why should you be the one scared that, oh, you might crash, you might have an accident? That guy has been trained, and he has passed through several turbulent, in fact, the training is such in such a way that you're going to simulate danger, as in maybe when you're, maybe like I said last time, maybe if you lose an engine, we study things like 180 glide, first land. Even if we lose an engine, we have the capacity to bring you back on ground safe and sound. I'm not excluding the fact that, okay, maybe a lot of accidents, like you heard of the recent Lion Air that got crashed. Oh, it's a pity about that, and several other crashes. But these guys have been so trained that no matter the event of an accident, they have the capacity to handle the situation. And that's why our training is not just a peripheral training. You go in depth. If you want to be a pilot, you have to be very disciplined in order to do this. So this is part of the reasons why you cannot crash. You have professional engineers that have released this aircraft and certified it to fly. Before an aircraft is released and before the pilot signs to take in that aircraft, it must have gone through several stages. As in the checks that have been done on that aircraft, there is what we call daily checks, routine checks, 50-hour check, 100-hour check. These checks happen, and without these checks, this aircraft cannot fly. So for the fact that the engineer released that aircraft, I need you to also trust in that engineer. That aircraft cannot crash. An additional pilot. Most aircraft carry nothing less than 2 crew members. Either you have 2 crew members, 4 crew members, 3 crew members, 6 crew members on board. I'm talking about pilots. And if, for instance, you say, oh, what if something is wrong with this pilot or something is wrong with this one? There is always somebody there to, you know, come into place. Well, I know maybe you've heard of the accident investigation that happened concerning the pilot that committed the suicide, locked the cockpit and committed the suicide and killed everybody in the aircraft. That's an exceptional case. Before you hear of those kind of things, it's 1 out of 1 million, for goodness sake. It doesn't just happen. In fact, that's why the FAA has given a rule, generally ECA has given a rule, that no you cannot have one person in the cockpit. Even if the pilot is out, the cabin crew or someone else has to stand in to make sure that there are always 2 people. So in case one person is kind of running mental, the other person can, you know, call him back to action. So I need you to know that flying is one of the safest means of transportation. Before you can hear of a crash, it's going to be 1 out of 1,000. Like if you compare it to road transportation, sea transportation, rail, and the rest of them, it's one of the safest and fastest means of transportation. So if you're considering the fact that, oh, I don't want to fly by air because I may crash, I need you to forget about that right now and take off that fear of. I need to have an aviator's mentality. I need to have an aviator's mindset, an aviator's perspective about this. They are just turbulence. They don't last for a very long time. And it's just in a particular area. So this should give you more confidence that no matter what's happening in this aircraft, I can't crash. That's a major thing I want to tell you today. You know, just have it at the back of your mind. You see people crying, oh, this, that, yeah, but have it at the back of your mind that this guy is trained to take me from me where I am to where I'm supposed to be. So I don't need it to maybe, and you know, of course, God, you definitely believe in God, so I don't see any reason why you should not trust him. For the fact that you went into that journey, I don't see any reason why you should not trust him. So I'm not excluding the fact in this video that crashes doesn't happen even when you have skilled pilots or when you don't have when you have very trained and experienced pilots. But I'm trying to tell you that you should put more of your don't forget about the worry and have confidence. You have the best pilots, you have the best engineers working on that aircraft, and you have additional pilots. So you have additional crew members in that aircraft to keep the aircraft safe. So you need to know that you're covered. So stay tuned to this TV channel. And if you're not subscribed, make sure you click on the subscribe button. We'll be sure to bring you the best of the best for aviation, motivation, and adventure.